It's a scorching summer's day. The sun's hot, the sand's hot, and so are we. Heat is a form of energy. Hot things have lots of energy. Cold things have a small amount of energy. And this heat energy flows or transfers from one thing to another. In this unit, we'll see how heat energy always travels from something hot to something cold, or from a hot part of something to a cold part, until both are the same. And how heat energy flows or transfers in three ways: by radiation, conduction, and convection.
Took you so long?
Well, it was so hot, so we went to get some ice.
Good idea, but I don't think it's going to last in this heat.
The sun's energy is carried to Earth by radiation, as electromagnetic waves, to be precise. Like a giant radiator, the sun is the major source of heat energy here on Earth. Heat flow by radiation doesn't need anything to travel through. It doesn't need particles of air, liquid, or anything solid. It can travel through nothing at all. So this is how the sun's energy travels through the vacuum of space. Having reached the Earth by radiation, this energy may be absorbed by the Earth's surface, as well as by things on it, and they warm up. The energy flows and spreads through these things in one of two ways, either by conduction or convection. When heat is transferred through a solid, like this knife that's out in the sun, this kind of energy flow is called conduction. The particles inside metals are especially good at conducting heat. When these tightly packed particles are heated, they gain more energy, vibrate more quickly, and the heat energy is swiftly passed along from one particle to another. By touching the hot metal object, the heat energy flows once again, very quickly, from the metal to Oriane's skin. The more energy there is, the hotter it feels. Heat flows because there is a difference in temperature. It always transfers from warmer objects or places, here the knife, to cooler ones, to Rishil or Oriane's skin. This is also true when something very cold is placed against someone's warm skin. Heat energy flows very quickly, but this time from the skin, which is warm, to the metal, which is cold. It's the sudden loss of heat from the skin which makes the metal feel very cold. It's heat that transfers, never the cold.
Hey guys, let's play volleyball.
Okay. All right.
Sun is shining, the weather is...
The third way that heat is transferred is by convection. Convection is how heat energy travels in moving currents through liquids and gases. Molecules actually move away from the source of heat, carrying energy with them. When a glass of water is placed on hot sand, heat will be transferred through the water by convection. When the particles of water in the bottom of the glass heat up, they move more quickly, spread out, and become less densely packed together than the cooler particles around them. They rise up through denser and cooler water to the top of the glass, and this cooler water sinks to the bottom, where it also gets heated up. This movement sets up a convection current, and eventually all of the liquid is heated up to the same temperature. I'm a rainbow too. Convection is also how heat travels in moving currents through gases. Hot air rises just like the particles of water in the glass. The particles in the air next to the hot sand spread out using heat energy from the sand. They become less dense than the cooler air above and rise up. This movement of warm air rising and cooler air sinking sets up convection currents. In gases, the particles are further apart, so the transfer of energy from one particle to another takes longer. Sometimes, this can be quite useful. It means that gases can be used to keep heat energy in or out of a container. This is known as thermal insulation. In this polystyrene cool box, the small pockets of air inside the polystyrene slow down the transfer of heat from the outside to the inside of the box. The sun's energy warms the outside of the polystyrene, but transfer of this heat is slowed down because in the small pockets of air between the polystyrene, the particles are further apart. In the air pocket, the transfer of energy from one particle to another takes longer. As a result, the heat takes more time to reach the next piece of polystyrene, and so the drinks are kept cool. Sometimes, all three kinds of heat energy transfer combine. With an iced drink, for instance, the sun's heat reaches the glass by radiation. This heat flows through particles in the ice by conduction, which eventually melts the ice. This cool water at the top of the glass is replaced by warmer water from the bottom by convection. It's amazing to think that energy from the sun can travel 150 million kilometres through space and still heat you up as you lie on the beach. But it's a relief to know that even on the hottest days, there are ways to cool down so you can keep chilling out.